So in this video, we are going to go over nutrients and water. So adding nutrients to your hydroponic system can seem daunting, but it's actually pretty simple. First, it is important to always add water and nutrients together. They work as a duo. You don't need to daily and constantly add water and nutrients to your hydroponic system. You can rely on the water level in the reservoir to indicate when it's time to add more water and nutrients. Simply add more solution to the system when the water level gets low, and you can go for weeks at a time without having to add more.
So the amount of nutrients that you will add will depend on the stage that the plant is and the amount of water that you're adding to the system. Each nutrients type, grow, micro, and bloom, has a specific ratio that you will need to follow. But don't worry, it's all outlined in the instructions. So plants have three stages of life. The first stage, which is the germination stage. And in this stage is when the seeds begin to sprout and the roots and stems start to develop. During this stage, the plant needs a good source of phosphorus to develop strong roots and potassium to regulate water uptake and nitrogen to support the development of leaves and stems. During this stage, just for simplicity, we recommend using the vegetative ratio, especially when you're first starting out. As you get more experienced and more comfortable with hydroponic growing, you can start to move to more of a germination ratio, but it is a little extra work.
So the next is the vegetative stage. So during the vegetative stage, the plants grow rapidly and develop leaves, stems, and branches. The focus during this stage is on building a strong and healthy plant structure. The plants require higher levels of nitrogen to promote leafy growth, as well as potassium and phosphorus for the root development and just overall health of the plant. So during this stage of the plant, you're going to want to use the vegetative ratio.
The third stage is fruiting and flowering stage. And in this stage, the plants start to develop flowers or fruits. The focus shifts from growth to reproduction, and the plants require a different set of nutrients to support this process. The plant needs higher levels of phosphorus and potassium to encourage flower and fruit development, and lower levels of nitrogen to avoid excessive leaf growth. So during this stage, you'll want to use the fruit and flowering stage nutrients ratios.
So in general, during each stage, the plant's nutrients requirements change as its growth and development progresses. It is important to provide the right balance of nutrients at each stage to support a healthy growth and maximize your yield.
So this brings us to the next question that you might be asking yourself. What do I do if I have a mix of plants in various phases, from blooming tomato plants to germinating seeds, and leafy greens and herbs all in full growth? It is a common conundrum for many gardeners, but don't worry, there is a solution to make your garden still thrive. The nutrients ratio will ultimately depend on your personal preference and the plants you want to favor to grow more. For instance, if you have a lot of leafy greens and herbs in your system and only a few flowering plants, you might just want to stick with the vegetative ratio, and this will promote the growth of those plants while still allowing the fruiting and flowering plants to produce fruit. On the other hand, if the majority of your plants are flowering, it's best to switch to the blooming ratio of nutrients, and this will encourage your plants to produce more flowers and more fruits, but it will slow down the growth of the leafy greens and herbs.
So there are a few tips and tricks you can use to give the plants that don't have the desirable nutrients ratio a little extra boost for growing. For example, so if you're using a vegetative ratio and growing flowering plants, you can mix in a spray bottle the bloom ratio and spray the flowering plants 1 to 2 times a day. And this is going to help your plants give it, because they're going to get the proper nutrients and they're going to be able to grow and thrive.
In the end, finding the right nutrients ratio for your plants is all about experimentation and observation. By taking the time to understand your plant's needs and making adjustments when necessary, you can create a thriving garden that will be the envy of all your neighbors.